These series of hills which stand out in the landscape are remnants of a truly catastrophic event which occurred 340,000 years ago at Mount Shasta. Known as Hummocky Terrain, they were formed when a large section of Mount Shasta collapsed at a massive landslide totaling 45 cubic kilometers of rock and moving up to 45 kilometers distant. While this is one of the most famous localities with this type of volcanic landslide generated landform, there is also a far more active volcano which has generated this feature during a several thousand year old landslide, Mount Galunggung. There, groupings of up to 40 meter or 131 foot high tree covered green hills dot the landscape over an area of 250 square kilometers. More easily visible from satellite, these features are referred to as the 10,000 hills of Tasikmalaya, although, despite the name, there are not 10,000 of them. Nevertheless, on a clear day, it is quite easy to see where on Galunggung they originated from. As a giant C-shaped chunk of the volcano representing 18 cubic kilometers of material is seemingly missing. Thus, these hills or hummocks originated from the eastern section of the volcano during a powerful eruption in 2695 BCE, and the location of Galunggung's 1982 eruption provides a clue as to how this exactly occurred. For context, the Galunggung volcano is located on the western third of the Indonesian island of Java, where it is approximately 175 kilometers southeast of the city of Jakarta. The Galunggung volcano is probably best known for its 1982 eruption, which is the third largest explosive volcanic eruption within Indonesia to occur during the 20th century. This eruption occurred at the same site of a smaller 1918 eruption, which created a 1,500 meter wide lava dome. Pressure then built up underneath the wide lava dome, before eventually bursting upwards in a series of powerful explosions in 1982. These explosions created a sustained plinian eruption column which shot to a height of 20 kilometers, and as part of this collapse downwards, it created superheated pyroclastic flows which scorched the landscape to up to a distance of 5,700 meters. In total, this eruption ejected approximately 0.4 cubic kilometers of volcanic rock, meaning it was assigned a volcanic explosivity index of a 4. Dozens of villages were destroyed, largely from lahars and heavy ashfall, but this eruption is best known for causing all four engines to fail on a commercial aircraft after it being caught in the ash cloud, along with another incident where three engines failed on an aircraft later in the eruption. Luckily, despite the significant damage to each aircraft, everyone on them landed safely and thus survived the incident. Along with a similar incident caused by the eruption of Mount Redoubt in 1989, this led to the creation of the VAC, or Volcanic Ash Advisory Center, which advises pilots worldwide and forecasts the direction eruption plumes take to prevent a repeat disaster from occurring. Despite how old the entire Galunggung volcano might appear, it only began forming around 35,000 years ago when a volume of basaltic andesite lava erupted onto the surface. Through dozens of strombolian to volcanian explosive eruptions, a gray-colored stratocone with possibly red size due to the presence of scoria was built. Three vents were intermittently active and placed along a north-northeast-to-south-southwest trending line. Eventually, a large explosive eruption carved out a 700-meter-wide and 120-meter-deep Guntur crater. While this remained the dominant crater for thousands of years, a large intrusion eventually occurred underneath the Galunggung's eastern flank. Just like seen at Mount St. Helens in 1980, a large cryptodome pushed up overlying rock by perhaps as much as 50 or more meters. Eventually, in 2695 BCE, a landslide occurred causing the underlying cryptodome magma to explosively erupt in a powerful eruption, simultaneously occurring as more than a dozen cubic kilometers of the mountain collapsed. This deposited the numerous hummocky terrain blocks and even caused a river to divert, leading to the creation of the Situgede Lake. The remnants of what was once a cryptodome have been the site of every historical eruption since, including a powerful VEI-5 eruption in 1822, which led to several thousand casualties through pyroclastic flows, ashfall, and lahars. Galunggung has not erupted since January of 1984, but since 1800 has erupted on average about once every 45 years. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.